Everybody, Montpellier.
Yeah!
Hey,
you're hot!
How you doing? Hey, looking good. Looking good. Anyone here gonna giggle rock? Or, I mean, sorry. Anyone gonna bottle rock? Across the street.
Ouch! Yes.
Yeah. 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 VIP packs. Anyone supporting a VIP pass?
Yeah,
you're special, you're rich, you get in there.
Yeah.
I was there for a little while,
but so,
it was
so
great.
Proud of it, I have one.
I didn't buy it, I stole it from someone.
Oh,
it was great,
right, yeah.
And I had it. Anyone, you could use like your own toilet, you got like your own veggie burger, you got a stick to hit people who didn't buy one. It was awesome. Just over the face. Fucking bastard. Sick. Anyway. So, yeah, who's here to draw? Anyone here wasted?
Yes!
I love going to a bar sober. You know, you meet some sort of like amateur anthropologist, start analyzing David Attenborough voice.
Back
here! Douchebag, because these environments. Now, look, he's talking to a blonde person that slept. Beware your clothes. It's awesome, right? You know what? I don't like to go to a bar and observe those guys or the jockey douchebags or the aged creepers. I like watching the Untouchables. You know, the pariah, the lowest caste of the bar. You know, they already have this crestfallen face. They're sad they left that house. What the fuck is that? They're sad they left that house. They look depressed. Their friends drug them out. You know, they weren't the same clothes. They fall asleep with the television on. So, they got Cheeto stains from the inside. They didn't want to go out, you know?
Yeah.
But they did. You know what? They're there in the movie. I'm pulling for them. You know, and even if they do get laid, which is rare, you know, they'll be happy. They're not going home alone like they always do, but it's going to be a bittersweet kind of sex. The kind of sex that reminds them of how much their body's deteriorated. How much age is full, you know, they get up, hang on, you know, oh, it'll get hard in a second. Like, oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, that's good. No, I'm cramping up. Move. Okay, not that I have surgery on that side. No, like this. Okay. Yeah. Oh, did you come? No, I feel like I lost your bag. Son of a bitch. Oh, this is a mess. This is so embarrassing. Oh, man. There's something I like, is I like running into girls when you, like in 8th grade, they were out, hello.
Move to the
other side.
Stand away from the speaker.
Yeah.
Move away from the
speaker. I'm not doing that out of my mind, I swear to God.
Are
my glasses
magnetic?
Hello? I can without a mic. This is a small.
You don't need a mic? Yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! There you go!
A chick, you see, who's bad at me, create a pudgy little outcast, you know, maybe send her a Facebook, see her profile, new pics, she's lost weight, she's got a style, she looks good, that's awesome, maybe you pound her out a message, try to fade nostalgia, and say, hey, we should come to catch up, you know, and talk about old times, it's great, you know, maybe get her at a bar, and that's awesome, if you do it fast enough, you do it quick enough, you'll get a hot chick with a fat chick mentality, you know what I mean? Good, but... She doesn't know it, you know, she still reads books, you know, she's up on current events, sporting events, you know, she doesn't get weird when she's eating in front of you, she's comfortable with that, you know, and she doesn't even know, she doesn't need a personality anymore, she has one, right? It's amazing. Oh, man, you're like Professor Xavier in the X-Men, like I discovered a new mutant, if you don't know the mutant powers yet, and I'm like, come with me, my child. I'll show you how to hone your skills. Here, wear this costume. Yes, the ass is missing, but no, it's supposed to. Just trust me. This'll work. That's the time. You know, and sex is good. You know, I'm sick of people getting hung up with sex. Sex is a great thing. It's a holy thing. It's in the Bible. Jesus was all about sex. I don't know if you knew that. I mean, he said that himself. Love thy neighbor. Could you be more clear? Do unto others as they do unto you? Well, I would have you do a blowjob unto me. Wouldn't that be great? And I'm sure there's a version of the Bible out there somewhere where this is just down in the record, you know? I mean, he's Jesus. He's going to be great at it. He's going to be miraculously good. He'd be like, 1 foot, you know, two hands levitating. He's like, and then like, crazy. And like, Peter's usually like, oh, tag us in. Okay, Judas goes last. Judas, you go last. And you deal with the leper. I know what you're about, Judas. Fuck. Because Jesus is hard, so he's like, fuck you, Judas. It's intense. But if you're gonna have sex, do it safe. Always protect yourself, you know. Be safe. Always wear a condom. No excuses, you know. Unless you can't come with a condom on, then fuck that. What's the worst that can happen? There are worse things in the world. There's terrorism. There's global warming. I mean, I don't even fuck that many people. Let's assume that I have every disease imaginable. Let's assume that my dick is now more tumor than cock. And just like, just sharing my job with you can give you herpes, right? Let's say I got all that. I'm not fucking that many people. You know, when the world ends and the cyborgs fight the U.S. and like the zombies rise and Johnny Radiant Press fight for dominance, it's not gonna matter. I gave Stacy the clap in eighth grade. Fuck you, Stacy. You made a big deal over nothing. You little bitch. Anyway, Alex. Anyway. I'm gonna shut up. We have a great comic coming up. He is a man of many talents. He is a man who has one of the funniest Twitter feeds. I normally hate Twitter. That I've had the privilege of reading. He's a great comic. His name is Jesse Elias. He's coming up right now. Thank you.
Yeah.
So I've been thinking about life a lot recently, and I thought to myself, and I think I came to an epiphany about life. I kind of wish it was either a lot better or a lot shorter. And I'm not a betting man, but if I had to guess which one of those scenarios was more likely to occur in my lifetime, it would be the shorter, right? This is the shit of it. Like, I'm not ready to kill myself. Like, I don't have it in me. I don't have the fucking balls. Like, I can't do it, but... Well, I should amend that statement. I can't do it right now. You guys are looking at me, but I have something to go for. I'm relatively young, relatively in shape. I appear Caucasian, which is fucking awesome. Super clutch. But that's not gonna last. I mean, I'm an idiot. I do dumb shit all the time. I could wrap my ass around a telephone pole. I could drink myself into a coma. Age. Just age all by itself is going to fuck me. I'm gonna lose my teeth. My dick's gonna stop working. I won't give a shit right. I mean, I'm miserable now. Do you understand what I'm saying? Like, I'm winning the game of life. And I'm still a depressed fuck. If something really bad actually happened to me, I couldn't take it. I would be gagging to kill myself. But, you know, whether or not I actually do it, whether or not I actually go through with it, I'll tell you this much. If I ever do kill myself, it's gonna be fucking epic. Okay? Like, your friends will link you on their newsfeed, like, oh my god, you should read this story, it's fucking crazy. Like, they'll interrupt the Big Bang Theory, they'll be running me in the bottom of your newsfeed and say, oh my god, what just happened? Like, confused news agents will come on and try to explain it, like, as far as we know, a massive Vietnam unidentified American male has broken into the Vatican, drugged his holiness to Pope, and tattooed a graphic image of an erect penis on his forehead. We'll give you the details as soon as we One of my favorite suicide scenarios. But I think my all-time favorite would be going to Australia, going to the Great Barrier Reef, you know, get a boat, you know, I'm on the boat, I'm chumming the water, I'm chewing the water, I see a tiger shark, I jump in, and I just fight it. I fight him with like a pair of brass knuckles I popped out in Tijuana on vacation, yes! And a yellow baguette. And I was like, fuck you. And I'm probably gonna die, but there's a slim chance that I win. Like maybe I stun him upside the head and I get the baguette and I jam it in his lifeless eyes. And if I won, that's a reason to live. Like that, who here wouldn't think that's awesome? What guy would buy me a beer if I killed Chuck? What would justify giving me a toothy blowjob in the back of my Vietnam Escort? And you defend me if you're like stuck in a protest. Oh my god, you look like an angry Mexican guy in the back of it. That's disgusting. Hey, you know what, bitch? Fuck you. Your boyfriend works at Jiffy Lube. This guy kills a shark with bread. I fucking win. I think that's what you want. I don't think that makes me suicidal. Like, I think about it all the time, so I'm sort of inured, I'm sort of inoculated to the idea. Like, if my life had been awesome up to a while, like, if everything in my life would just fulfill me mentally, physically, emotionally, like, I was set, and then I all of a sudden start thinking about suicide, that would fuck me up. That would be like, oh my god, I never thought of this before. I might do it, but my life has sucked, so I think about it all the time. It's like my comfort food. I just look around, and I just think, oh, look at all these solutions to my problems. Look at all the ways I can die. You know, cars, bridges. It's amazing. It's kind of weird I'm still alive. Considering that, and if you really think about it, it's weird that any of us are alive at all, right? It's kind of insane. So, But you know, suicide, most of those things. Do you come through with it? Do you don't? I don't think we do. I think that we live life the best we can, and, you know, we hope we can, we hope we don't get AIDS, and that's it, right? That's the best you can do. Calm down, we just get AIDS. Kim knows when we come out, she is an amazing comic. She does great dirty haiku, which you should read. She's a Bay Area comic, and she's amazing energy. Thanks, Caitlin Gill. Menstruation. I think it's awesome. You haven't earned your red beard yet? What the fuck are you doing?
What? Yeah!
I'm a man, dude. This relationship I have trouble navigating. I don't know if you guys can relate. Have you ever met someone and they suck, but their pet is awesome? Like, how do you deal with that? Like, is it okay to just, like, come up on the dude's after, like, hi, hello? Yo, what's up? Is Mr. Wiggles here? I know you. Didn't we meet last week? Yeah. Whatever. Do you really want to meet my cat? Hey! Google, what's up? Dude, what's your name? I didn't even get your name. My name's no fucking worry about it, dude. It's all good. Come on, Mr. Wiggles. Dude, your roommate's a dick. Fuck that guy. Did anyone hear of a friend? He just, like, has no objective quality whatsoever. They just, like everything. Everything's relative to them. Schindler's List, Transformers, Dark Side of the Moon, it's all the same. You know, it's, they don't care, right? You know, those are the kind of people who like Kevin James films. Okay? And I've come to a realization about Kevin James. The same kind of people who think Kevin James is funny are the same kind of people who deny the Holocaust. It's really simple. There's not many of them. They're generally ashamed of what they are. And Jews hate them. I'm not new to that. Yeah, Jews and everyone who likes Kevin James. Long story, I can explain it to you. He's Satan, okay? Paul Blart Mall Cop is Satan. That's all you need to know. That's the whole story. That's it. I want to end the stand-up portion behind him, because I'm kind of a dark fuck, and I apologize for that. Deep down, I'm an optimist. I think the best of everyone. I think everyone's basically a decent person. Maybe stupid, but generally decent. You know, and if you're a person of faith, take part. You know, there's somebody out there watching over you, and sure, God does allow terrible things to happen to good people every day. But it's not because he doesn't care or he's callous. It's because he thinks it's hilarious. Right? I mean, they never see it coming. They're good. I'm sorry. That's a poor kid. Just kidding. There's no fucking God. Were you drunk? I'm supposed to be ill. We had Caitlin Gill. We had Jesse Elias. Amazing guy. Watchables. I'll touch them. Right back. Welcome to coming up. Thank you very much for being here.